Thank you. I'm very impressed you memorized all of that, actually. So, good afternoon. My name is Sean Lessman. I am, for the purposes of this presentation, the VP of Business Development. I hold the relationship with Cisco for our company, so this is the role I play in the, for this presentation. But I also manage the federal and public sector practice for the organization as well. So if you happen to be a federal agency and organization, please stop by afterward to have a chat with me specifically. And we also have our enterprise and commercial folks here as well. So to get started, this is a topic that's it's got a lot of details behind it. So we're going to touch on a lot of high-level information today. But we encourage you to come by the booth afterwards to talk about more of the details, okay? It's a very complex conversation. So that being said, the platform we make does quite a few things, but we're going to focus on a very specific message today, and I want you to take away three things. Number one, we simplified the multi-vendor meeting environment. What that means is, in this day and age, most organizations and agencies have more than one meeting platform. Some are very common to have two or three, in fact. So the idea is, how do we make these devices that you use every day more flexible and more valuable by allowing them to connect these different meeting platforms easier? Number two, our platform is not CVI. So if you don't know what CVI means, it means Cloud Video Interop. It's a common technology in the market that allows for interoperability between SIP devices and Microsoft Teams. While we're not CVI, we do solve a lot of the same issues CVI does. We just do it in a different way, okay? And Synergy Sky is the only independent player in the interoperability market. And what I mean by that is we can come help take all the platforms you have, the endpoints, meeting platforms, and so on, to make them work, and we're not going to ask you to buy our endpoint or our meeting platform or some other technology that you may already have. Okay, so we're about taking what you have decided on already and making it work for you. From an executive summary standpoint, with our partnership with Cisco, I did want to bring up a few points because sometimes it can get confusing. Sometimes you hear messaging that says, well, Cisco accomplishes this, why do I need Synergy Sky? The reality is that we're brought in as a partner because we fill a lot of the gaps that are in the portfolio, specifically for certain areas like the federal government and so on. And here's some of the areas of why we get brought into certain opportunities. We integrate with all the major calendar platforms on the market today. So Microsoft Exchange on-premise, Office 365, for the federal teams, the GCC, GCC High, GCC DoD. We even do Google and Google FedRAMP as well. We do multi-vendor one button to push. It's actually where we got started. So the idea there is if you have Cisco, maybe you have some polys, we can do the one button to push experience for all those devices. And we support both brands pretty much the last 10 or 12 years. So C-Series and above, if you were a Tamron customer that far back, we can support it. On the poly side, HDX and above. Multi-vendor analytics, multi-vendor platform connect and CVI support. We support all the major CVIs in the market today, so it doesn't matter which brand or flavor you have. We can get you that single easy join button for any of those CVI platforms. We support all the older Cisco gear, so if you have some older stuff and some newer stuff, we can give that single experience. And we're registration independent, so we do not require you to be part of the Webex cloud. You can be an on-premise or call manager or VCS customer, and everything we talk about today will work for you. Next bullet point on expanding Cisco CVI, we can work in parallel with the Cisco VIMT product. We can also add additional features into the conversation as well. And this last part down here is it's not just enough to get you connected. We can actually make your Cisco devices play a little nicer in a Microsoft Teams environment. So to get started, I did a webinar a few months back. Actually, it was St. Patrick's Day. And I was invited to come on and talk about what we do and how we help the Cisco solutions. And this was a poll they did for the audience right before I started. And the question was, you know, what are your common pain points when joining multiple meeting platforms? And what bubbled up to the top was different experience. And what they mean by that, if you think about it, is I'm trying to join different meeting platforms. It's very common nowadays to have to change your user experience to do so. You either download the software client, you join by a browser, maybe you take your laptop and do a USB pass through, these sort of approaches. But what's happening is your user experience is changing for each one of these meetings. And that's frustrating some people. They like to have a single experience for all their meeting types. A number of these other areas down here we also solve for as well. We're going to talk about here in a bit through the presentation. For us, the experience starts, so we have basically two user experiences. and there's a bunch of administrative experiences, right? The user experiences, we actually don't introduce to you at all. We utilize the user experiences you're already using today. The first one is the calendar system. We do not introduce any new plugins, no new workflows, so you'll get nothing from us, but you can use your plugins or add-ins from Microsoft Teams, for Webex, for Zoom, and so on. That's completely fine. What's going to happen is you're going to book that meeting, it's going to generate an invite. Our platform will read the invite and abstract all the information it needs to develop that SIP dial string to make the call happen. Okay, so we're not, it's all about how you generate the invite, it's up to you. We're going to read the invite and make the dial string. The second user experience is the one button to push experience. Once again, not an experience that we've created, something that lives natively in the endpoints, and all we're doing is triggering it, turning it on, and providing a value. So when you push that button, what does it dial? That's up to us, okay? So that's what we were doing up until last fall. And what we noticed over the pandemic, you guys have probably all seen this as well, you may have been a single sort of brand type organization, but what happened over the pandemic, people were kind of sent home on a Thursday, right, to say, start working from home. And down to the team level, people started acquiring technologies to survive. So, you know, get out your credit card, buy some Zoom, buy some Webex, if we've got some Microsoft Teams already, let's start deploying. And what you found was, you have a big mix of stuff. And that worked fine when you're at home and you're using that one platform all day long for your team. But now that people are trying to get back into the office, people have their favorite technologies, right? They want to stick with what they know. And it's all not compatible, it's hard to know how to book it. That new shiny device I have in the boardroom from Cisco, how do I book it? I haven't used it, right? I haven't been in the office for 2 years. How do I make this easy? So what we started to look at was what's causing all this complexity and confusion in the market, and there's a different number of different platforms the market causing challenges, right? The first one we wanted to look at was Microsoft. It's a very big player in the market. They're everywhere. Everybody has some sort of Microsoft strategy, right? But it's also not compatible with the traditional SIP devices on the market today. So we wanted to like talk to our customers and understand what about Microsoft makes it complex and confusing and hard to use. As you know, Microsoft has a technology called CVI. It's a framework that other vendors adopted to sort of provide the ability for you to ask people to join your Microsoft Teams meeting, and it works very well. But the challenge with CVI is if you receive an invite from outside your organization, somebody sends you an invite, it doesn't allow for you to join that other meeting, unless they also have CVI on their side. So that's where the confusion comes in. Okay. On the third bullet point, the way that the larger players in the market would like to solve for that is this concept called direct guest join, which is fine. And the idea behind that is the endpoint will actually connect WebRTC into their to the other platforms, to the other meeting platforms. Right? Requires you to have the latest and greatest endpoints in the market. You know, it's got some limitations today with sharing content. All things that will be resolved as we go forward, but today, the current status is, it's, you know, it's not as friendly as it could be. And the very last bullet point, this is something that's special to me, because I work with the federal business, there was just a lack of federal solutions for CVI in general. So this, for a long time, you didn't have an option if you wanted to do CVI for the federal market. This is kind of what it looks like today. If you look at anything SIP-based, it's not a problem to get you connected today. Endpoint is natively compatible with SIP and get you connected. The ones causing the most problem, ironically, are the bigger names in the market. So you've got the Microsoft we talked about, the need for CVI to get you connected. Zoom also has something called CRC. Right, it's the same sort of concept. You got this gateway technology you got to have to get into the call, and they make you pay for it. And then Google Meet also has a very similar challenge as well. So the idea is it gets very complex for people to understand how is it that I have to connect, right? What do I have to dial? How do I have to book things and so on? We want to solve that problem. There's a number of ways to solve this problem in the market today. So it's commonly called, you know, the B2B problem. You know, I get an invite from a different platform that I'm not used to using, and how do I join that call? If your goal is to have a single user experience, something that's easy, like we looked at the poll earlier, if that's your goal, which is our goal, let's take a look at these technologies based on, through that lens. One way to solve that problem is USB pass-through. Does everybody know what that is? That's the idea of using your hardware device as a sort of a fancy web camera. Okay, so I bring my laptop with my specific software coding on it, Zoom, Webex, you know, Microsoft Teams. I bring it to the conference room. I use USB. I get access to the high quality camera, high quality microphones and speakers of the system itself, but the codec is in my laptop. It doesn't solve for that user experience problem we talked about, right? Because the user experience is now dictated by the meeting type. So it works, but it can also be confusing for people. Another way to solve this is to download the multiple software clients, right? We've all done that. You get invited to a meeting, you're 2 minutes late, you click the link to join, it tells you you have to download something. You know, you get it, you're already late, you join the meeting, and now it's a different experience, you don't know how to share your content and so on, right? So multiple user experiences. Another one is native endpoints. Okay, so the idea here is to, I'm primarily a Microsoft house, I'm primarily a Zoom house, so I'll just go and go all in and buy a native endpoint that works really well in that environment. But what you're doing here is you're just pushing the problem somewhere else. So while an MTR may work very well in a Microsoft environment, if you want to join Webex, it gets complicated again, right? Just an update on this one down here, but the Android device is not doing direct guest join. That's something that has, since this PowerPoint's been submitted, has something that's been released by Microsoft. So the Polys of the world, I don't think about Neep. I think Poly and one of the other vendors has now implemented that. So I just wanted to update the crowd. When you're looking at that, that's been changed. And lastly, where we're focused is actually providing that one user experience as a network service, okay, to solve the problem. So the experience stays the same the whole time. The experience is your Cisco endpoint, no matter what meeting platform you're joining. And we're focused, and there's two ways to solve that. One is an all-native sort of Cisco solution based on Cisco devices, direct guest join, hybrid calendar, and VIMT, and Webex, and so on. And the last one down here is what we do, and that's by layering in Synergy Sky and Synergy Sky Connect, we can do the same thing to provide you the that single user experience, sharing your content, and so on. A lot of details in those two different solutions. Please come by and meet us at the booth, and we'll go through those with you. Okay, so again, our focus, that's the technology we talk about. What does it do for the users? It provides an easy experience for scheduling, which is basically your calendaring system, all the ones we support here, an easy experience for joining, push a button, no longer have to like look through a long invite from a calendar invite to understand what you got to dial. You just push the button and connect. And then the goal here is to all these meeting platforms, the exact same experience for the user. The ones in black are the ones we support today. We even support the on-premise meeting platforms like Cisco CMS. The ones in gray are ones that are planned for the future. So think about this, categories being native SIP meeting platforms, we support all of them. When it comes to the non-native SIP platforms, the first one on the list is Microsoft Teams, and then additional ones will be coming down the pipe as well. A couple details about Connect, what makes it different from CVI and other solutions like this in the market. We present the call to Microsoft Teams as a WebRTC connection. That means it can connect to anybody's Microsoft Teams call. It doesn't matter if you're invited to one or you generated the invite internally. If you receive a Microsoft Teams invite, you can join their Microsoft Teams call as well. It also means you can join anything from commercial Microsoft Teams all the way up to GCDOD. In fact, we were demonstrating that yesterday. We had some federal customers come by and do a call from our booth into an Impact Level 5 DOD conference yesterday. So come by, challenge us, see if we can get into your Teams call, generate a Teams invite from your phone, and invite one of the endpoints at the booth. We preserve the native Microsoft Teams experience. We don't change any of the layouts, any of the experience. You're just a native Microsoft Teams participant. We support PowerPoint Live, things that CVI does not do today. Receiving whiteboards from the Microsoft Teams meetings. No need to attach yourself to the Teams tenant as a third-party integration or bot. This is something you have to do with CVI. Because of our WebRTC connection, that's not required. Again, for the federal people out in the audience today, any level of Microsoft Teams you can connect to, no problem. FedRAMP's not a requirement because it's not a SaaS product. So while in the commercial world, we do have a SaaS cloud you can utilize, in the federal government, it's a self-hosted solution. So something that was 100% can be air-gapped and you can use on your premise. Not a CVI, Cisco, I'm sorry, Cisco, Microsoft is something we've gone through with Microsoft. They agree, no requirements for CVI certification because it's not a CVI. And it's something that's included in the Synergy Sky suite license. What that means is you acquire our product, you simply license it by endpoint, however many endpoints you want to support, and everything we talked about today is included. It's one license. Some quick overviews for some of the folks in the audience that might be confused about Connect versus CVI. Joining internal, external invites, yes, we do that with Connect. CVI is all about you inviting people to your meeting. The different Microsoft Teams meetings supported. I put a star here on the CVI side because specifically the Cisco one does not do the federal versions, but there is another option on the market that does some of the federal options as well. Support for PowerPoint Live and Whiteboard, yes. No for CVI, you'll get a black screen on CVI. So if you're using CVI today and somebody fires up a PowerPoint Live on the meeting the team side, you'll get a black screen. Support for BFCP, this means the content share from the endpoint back into the Teams meeting, something that's being worked on for us right now. So again, we've developed towards the PowerPoint Live and Whiteboard. The last one on the list is the dual content from a SIP endpoint. But that is supported by CVI today. So when we're done, we'll get all three versions, no black screens, and be good to go. And most importantly, we're not just a Microsoft-only solution. Our focus is any meeting platform, where CVI is really a Microsoft-focused technology today. So in closing, or actually, one last thing. This is something we'll show at the booth as well. Once you're in a Microsoft call, or a Microsoft environment, sorry, you can generate meetings in several different ways. One is through the calendaring system, book a call, get a green button, push, and connect, right? We support that today. Receive an invite externally, invite your endpoint, push the button, connect. And the last one, which is pretty cool, is you can now go into any Cisco endpoint that has a navigator or touch 10, start a Teams meeting from the navigator, include the endpoint you want to include, they'll get green buttons, and you can start a call right away. So it's a sort of an ad hoc way of starting a call from the room, from a Cisco device for Microsoft Teams. Snapshot, you can see it live at the booth. If you want to come by and take a look, we'll show it to you. Everything we talked about so far was user-focused. Last on the list is we do have a lot of administrative tools. There's white glove functionality, kind of like if you're a TMS user today, the ability to kind of do conference control system or conference control from TMS. We could do very similar for both the Cisco CMS and PEXIP Infinity. We can do white glove at the endpoints as well. So if we have Cisco endpoints, we can do some mute, unmute, connect, disconnect, even if you're talking to Zoom, for example. Analyze is an analytics package we have that does, you know, sort of the basic call detailing or and information. We can track the number of platforms you're connecting to, give you trends up and down, what brands of meetings you're having, and so on. So in summary, we're about making it easy for users to schedule, easy buttons to join, get you connected to any of the meetings you need to be connected to, whether you were generated internally or externally, and the user experience stays the same, which is your Cisco video endpoint. Three takeaways we talked about from the beginning, right? Not a CVI, different way of doing it, has a lot of advantages to it, simplifying multi-vendor meeting environments, and of course, being an independent player, we don't introduce new things to the opportunities. And if I had to sum it up, if your boss is telling you, I just want to walk into a room, push a button, and connect, I don't care what the meeting platform is, that's what we do. Okay? Please come see us at the booth. Thank you.